We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss a very important topic related to utilization of electrical engineering, and this topic is classification of electrical heating. So let us go on this topic. So here it is. So this is Professor Rajesh Yadav from Shankar Singh Waghela Bapu College of Engineering, Gandhinagar. So first question arises, what is electrical heating? So as we can see, electrical heating is a process in which with the application of electrical energy, we can convert it to heat. So electrical energy, basically it will be in form of voltage. There will be something related to voltage and current, and because of that we will be getting electrical heat. So basically electrical heating is a process in which electrical energy is converted to heat. Common applications include space heating, cooking, water heating, industrial process, and so many. So let us go in detail. So what is that? That is classification of electrical heating. So electrical heating can be classified in these broad categories, these three broad categories. One is power frequency, high frequency, microwave heating. So actually we can also say that DC heating. But according to frequency, we can generalize, power frequency, that means supply we are using, which is in range of 50 to 60 hertz, and high frequency, that means it is above that, and 5 to 500 kilohertz, and above that there is microwave heating. The question is which we are going to study is this resistance. The broad categories are resistance heating, arc heating, induction heating, dielectric heating, infrared heating, then microwave heating. So in GTU, the question is we reply in that way, that classification of heating is like this: resistance heating, arc heating, induction heating, dielectric heating, that is frequency, high frequency, capacitance heating also. We will go in detail of that. Then infrared heating and microwave heating. So let us go one by one. Let us discuss one by one what we mean by these. So let us come to this resistance heating. Resistance heating is basically dependent on a very fundamental or very fundamental significant effect of current. That is what, whenever current is passing through a resistance, there will be always generation of heat. Why? Because of the electrons, the flowing electrons will be always getting collision inside your conductor. That is a continuous process. So because of that, every time electrons are moving through the conductor, they are getting getting energy from the supply, then they are hitting, getting collision with the atoms and losing their kinetic energy in form of heat. So because of that, there will be generation of heat, that is known as resistance heating. There are two types, direct and indirect. We will discuss about that, but let us discuss first the broad categories of electrical heating. Okay, so resistance heating works on a very, very significant and very, very general principle. That is what, whenever current flows through a conductor, there will be always generation of heat. Okay, so and according and the equation that governs it, that is I square RT. Okay, now let us see arc heating. What is arc heating? So basically arc heating means whenever we are putting two metals electrically separated with each other, and two metals are or plates are kept with near each other, and such way that the distance between both is very limited. Why it is so very limited? So and we are applying very high voltage difference on these two plates. One is kept very high at very high voltage and one is kept at very low voltage. That means basically we are applying a very high voltage difference on these two plates, and these two plates are electrically separated with each other. Then there will be generation of heat between these two plates. Why there will be generation of heat? Because when there is very high voltage difference between these two plates and they are electric, distance between them is very low, so because of that electric field E equal to V upon D will be very, very high, and because of that high electric field there will be breakdown and ionization of the dielectric medium. So in actually now that insulating medium will be no more insulating medium, and there will be flow of current, and because of that there will be generation of electric heat, and that is known as arc heating. So mind it, arc heating is dependent on level of voltage, it is not dependent on current. Okay, if you compare resistance heating, there the heating is dependent on current. We don't require very high voltage over there. We require only current. If you can get that that current from very low voltage also, then also it is possible to get a resistance heating. Okay, so that is very fundamental difference between these two, that resistance heating works on the mostly dependent on current, while arc heating is dependent on voltage. Okay, let us go ahead. Now induction heating. So induction heating is we all are familiar with the effect of Michael Faraday or the mutual induction principle, in which we know whenever magnetic flux linked with any coil or any metallic surface is cutted or varies with respect to time, then there will be generation of EMF in that surface or in that coil, and that EMF amplitude of that EMF is given by minus d phi by dt. That is known as Michael Faraday's law. So keeping that thing in mind, we can use it to get EMF, and that EMF will make a circulation of current in that coil or in that material, and ultimately that current will generate heat in that material, and we can use it as a heating purpose. So that is the idea of induction heating. So what is there in induction heating? So induction heating basically works on the principle of induction, in which first we will cut the magnetic flux related with the coil or with the surface, and because of that there will be generation of EMF, and that EMF, it if provided a closed path, there will be generation of current, and because of that current we will be getting heat in that coil or in that surface. So that thing can be used for the purpose of induction heating. Now, dielectric heating. So dielectric heating, basically basically dielectric heating, its name indicates that this heating method is used basically to heat out the dielectric materials or insulating materials. And how does it work? So it works on a very fundamental principle, or basically this is nothing but a capacitor. What is capacitor? So when you are putting two electric plates electrically separated with each other, that construction is known as capacitor. So mind it, if you are applying a current supply voltage to a capacitor, current cannot flow through it in ideal cases, because in between there is a dielectric. So how can current pass through that? So basically current cannot pass through that, but there is an effect. What is that effect? So that effect says that there is something like displacement current and or polarization. Because of that, there will be alignment of on microscopic level. There will be alignment of dipoles or alignment of plus and minus charges. And because of that, there will be a movement of charges, and because of that, we will be getting some current. And if it is a DC supply, so once that alignment is perfect, there will be no flow of current. But if it is a AC supply, so once this alignment is like this, in the second cycle it will be like this. So plus minus they are rotating or moving, and because of that we will be getting current inside of a dielectric. So if there is a current inside a dielectric, but obvious there will be heat according to I square RT, because dielectric it is itself having very high resistance. But if I can get a very low current through the dielectric from the mechanism I mentioned, so we can get a very sufficient amount of heat, and that fundamental principle is used for the heating purpose of dielectric. So that is known as dielectric heating. Next is infrared heating. We all know about that. Then there is a microwave heating. That is also, we are very well aware of that. So these are the basic classification of electrical heating. So I think it's sufficient up to here. Okay, we also need to discuss about what we mean by direct heating and indirect heating. So any heat, if it is produced inside the thing to which you want to heat up, then it is known as direct heating. But if the heat is produced outside of the substance to which you want to heat up, and it is conveyed up to that thing to which you want to heat up, then that is known as indirect heat. For example, if I am starting my stove and I am putting my vessel on above that, so heat is produced over here, but my vessel is above that flame. So heat should propagate. So that is indirect type of heating. But suppose if flame itself is induced inside the utensil or vessel, so in that case it will be a direct heating. There are various examples. So that is the idea. Okay, thank you for watching. Thank you.